item that we have is a 2016 pavement maintenance program. And this is a motion, of course, permitting engineer sites to prepare specifications and for me to advertise. Two streets on this list are there because the Pennsylvania American Water Company did work on 50% of the street. So they'll be paying for 50% of the pavement, so that's a plus for us because we'll only have to pay half. That's Harding and Forbes. The other street that we're proposing to do this year is Union Street, and that's from Bowerville to Terrace. It's in some pretty bad shape up there. It hasn't been done for about 20 years.
Probably, yeah.
And we need some curbs there too. So that's what we're proposing this year. The funds available are $158,000. We actually had another street listed in here, but that would take us over budget, and we think we can get another year of it. We do have a listing of our road program, and when they're when they are up for repaving or doing some maintenance or whatever, but it was going to take us about $40,000 over budget, so we'll wait till next year. The next item that I have is ordinance number 989, and this is an ordinance requested by the Public Safety Committee regarding parking on Bank Street Extension. That's regarding the placement of 6 parking spaces on the southerly side of Bank Street, as requested by the Parking Authority. And the next item is ordinance number 990. And this is just amending the code ordinances so that the parking authority may place the meter parking spaces in those locations. So that will take care of both of those items. We'll be able to move forward with that. We've got a lot of payments. Current estimate number 2 for the 2015 lining contract. That's going to be $27,363.60 to Jet Jack. And that's for work completed to date. Current estimate 3 and final is for a 2015 lining contract, and that will be the final to Jet Jack for $27,026. So they'll be finaled out and done. Current estimate number 3 and final for the 2015 CCTV project, that will be $3,033.53 to Insight Pipe, and that will be finished. Current estimate number 4 and final, that's a 2014 CCTV project, and that just seemed to continue on and on and on because we had change orders because we were having all types of problems. So that will be an amount of $14,800.12. I think we were waiting for a lot of punch list items for
We were waiting for a lot of punch list items. The biggest problem we had there with that one was they kept saying that they were giving us the videos, and we weren't getting the videos, so that's what drug that on along. So we finally got everything and then cut them off.
Okay, and the last item that I have is a motion authorizing the termination of the contract with First Energy for the current mercury vapor and high pressure sodium streetlights, and approving a contract on a month-to-month basis for the conversion of the streetlights to Cobra Head LED lighting. And as a remark, First Energy owns, we have 400 streetlights within the borough of Bridgeville. The conversion will work like the savings of between 30% and 50%. We have already noticed that because we are converted everywhere else with LED. It calculates to an approximate dollar savings of $26,000. There have been a few municipalities that have signed on already. North Fayette did, South Fayette did, we did, so now we're in the hopper. They ordered approximately 58,000 lights. What they said they're going to do is they're going to probably have contractors do these things. So they're looking probably starting ours toward the end of 2016, but we're in line now. So what they'll do is as they place the Cobra heads, they'll give me sheets of paper that will tell me exactly where they place them, what the pole numbers are and those type of things. So we'll be able to track where they are, where they still need to go and that type of thing. So as far as the agenda, that is all I have, so.
Phil, did you have something you wanted to bring up?
Yeah, the police contract we negotiated, we left that clause open to consider the drop pension. That is, we left it open until April 1st. They have an actuary in place they will want to present to our group. We either need to meet before April 1st and have this presentation, or extend that open clause 30 days and have them meet us before next meeting, one way or another. I think we owe them to allow them to present to us, so.
What would you want to do?
I think if we do it before the next, I don't know how easy it is to extend that clause, but.
It's easy enough to extend that clause, but then you have to face the government.
Right, that's what I'm thinking. It'd be best if everyone heard it and had a chance to see it, so.
So you want to add, extend that?
I'd say let's extend it 30 days and then we'll have it presented before the next meeting.
It's 30 days before the next meeting?
Yes, the latest it could be, right?
You just extend it through.
Yeah, right, it is.
We just extend through the April.
You do that. That's what I meant, 30 days from April. It's set to expire.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
In terms of that clause, we are just in the presentation, we have to decide on the issue.
Make a decision. You know, I don't know if we have to make a decision prior to those 30 days. I'm assuming we'll probably do it.
Probably should.
I might suggest if you're going to have a presentation at the April meeting, you may want to extend 60 days so that you get the May meeting, get a chance to digest, and then can make a thoughtful decision at the May meeting.
That makes sense.
I think what will need to happen is whatever they present, because I give them information from our actuary. So whatever they present is going to need to go over to our actuary who represents our best interests to give their opinion on what they're presenting.
They'll have no problem with the extension of 60 days. They're anxious to get something presented to us.
So we'll say an extension of 60 days.
Right now.
We need to bring it up tonight at the meeting.
Yeah, we'll bring it up. We can make a motion to extend it 60 days.